to right-click an empty spot from the taskbar, and then select Task Manager. If you see this small window, click More Details. Now click the Performance tab and then go to the Memory section from the left side. Now look at the bottom right corner of the window. Right here, what do you see? Now you can see the speed of your RAM. Now as you can see here, in my case, since I have DDR3 RAM, my speed here is about 1600 MHz. And your speed may vary depending on what generation of RAM you have especially, such as DDR2, DDR3, DDR4, DDR5, and so on. But you see, Windows 10's Task Manager only tells you part of the story. There is another factor we need to take into consideration. That is latency, specifically CAS latency. And again, here too, checking CAS latency is really simple. And to do that, we are going to download a free, interesting little program called CPUC, and I have a link to it in the video description. Once you have downloaded and installed CPUC, go to the Memory tab. And now, where you see CAS latency or CL, there it is. That's the CAS latency. So as you can see here, in my case, with a speed of 1600 MHz, my CAS latency is 11. But wait, something is wrong here. From the Task Manager, it said my clock speed was 1600, and here it says it's 800. Well, remember the principle of RAM, dual channel memory, and double data rate. And because CPU-Z is more specific, it gives me the single data rate. Alright, now the question is, how do I use this kind of information, that is CAS latency and speed, to figuring out which type of RAM to buy? After all, speed does not tell you everything and CAS latency does not tell you everything. To figure this out, all you have to do is divide CAS latency by the clock speed. And the lower the result, the better. Alright, let's try it out. We are going to try it out in my system first. And then we are going to act like we are buying RAM online, so that way we can compare which RAM is best for the price. In my case, I have a clock speed of 1600 and a CAS latency of 11. So all I have to do is divide 11 by 1600. Now let me open the calculator and do the math. And there you go, this is the value. Now as you can see, it's some weird decimal number, but like I said, the smaller the value, the better. Now if you want a friendlier value, you can always multiply that by 2000, but you don't have to. That'll give you the true latency. But again, the key is this, the lower the value, the better. Alright, let's try this out. Let's pretend to be buying RAM. And to do this, we are going to visit Newegg, and we are going to try to buy some DDR4 memory. Alright, and I've already pre-selected some RAM, and all of them have a clock speed of 2666 MHz. And now when considering CAS latency, let's find out which one of them is faster. Alright, as you can see, in the first two sets of RAM, there is a price difference. But is that price difference because of aesthetics, the way they look, or because of the CAS latency? What's nice about Newegg is that it's really easy to figure out the CAS latency. If I go to the specifications right here, as you can see, it tells me the CAS latency. And in this case, for this RAM module, it is 16. Okay, now let's do the simple math. Divide the CAS latency, 16, by the clock speed, 2666. As you can see, this is the value I get. And of course, if you want a friendlier value, you can multiply it by 2000. And there you go, this is the true latency. Alright, now let's try the next set of RAM. As you can see, it has the same clock speed, but it is cheaper. If I go to specifications here, as you can see, it has the same CAS latency. So therefore, you don't even have to do any math. You get the same performance out of this RAM. So we can conclude that the first set that you saw, it's more expensive because of the way it looks. It has that extra flair to it. So now you can really, really see the value of the RAM. And now let's try this set of RAM. Again, same clock speeds, but different CAS latencies. Well, this one, the cheaper one, has a CAS latency of 19. And this one, which is more expensive, has a CAS latency of 15. Again, same clock speed, so therefore, clearly, the more expensive one gives you the better performance. And finally, let's try this one. It has a clock speed of 3200 and a CAS latency of 16. Again, simple math, 16, the CAS latency divided by 3200, the clock speed, and this is the result I get. Again, for a friendlier value, I can multiply by 2000, and here you go, this is the true latency, a true latency of 10. So if your motherboard can support that, then this will definitely yield better performance. So there you go, that's it. This is how you check RAM speed on Windows 10. Remember, you can use a task manager to figure out your overall RAM speed. And then, let's say you want to figure out the true latency, then you can use CPU-Z to check for the CAS latency and do the basic math, which is CAS latency divided by the clock speed times 2000 for a simpler value. And finally, let's say you're trying to buy a new RAM and you try to compare it with that of your system, then you can use those calculations to make an effective choice. If you have any suggestions as to what to look for to buy a good RAM, please leave those on the comments below. So for more simple, easy, straightforward, yet informative videos like this, please subscribe and thanks for watching.